Something is wrong with Jupiter. In addition to studying planets, scientists also examine the planet's weather and how it affects the Earth. Now, it has been discovered that there are storms in Jupiter that are 1.3 times as big as Earth and are roaring with an unfathomable amount of fury. Keep watching this video to get the full details. What's going on with Jupiter, and why is it crucial that its weather remains favorable? 9 cyclones swirling in Jupiter's North Pole have recently caught the attention of scientists. The strange storms on Jupiter, which a NASA satellite spotted back in 2017, have caught the attention of experts, and how the 9 cyclones rotating at Jupiter's North Pole maintain their organization is now the subject of recent research. One of the numerous storms on the gas giant Jupiter, the Great Red Spot, is an anticyclone, a collection of spinning storm clouds. The NASA Juno probe, which orbits Jupiter, initially discovered a family of 9 cyclones, one huge storm surrounded by 8 smaller ones, at the planet's North Pole in 2017. Why this configuration has remained consistent over the past few years, if not since its discovery, was the subject of a study published in Nature Astronomy. The study's authors note that the Juno spacecraft has, since 2017, noticed a large cyclone surrounding 8 smaller cyclones that are grouped in a polygonal configuration at Jupiter's North Pole. Similar patterns can be seen in Jupiter's South Pole. However, this pattern displays 5 storms instead of 8. The polygons. The researchers refer to the geometric North and South Pole storm systems as polygons, and they state that they have remained constant for 4 years since Juno first spotted them. The Jovian Infrared Auroral Mapper on Juno provided the researchers with a sequence of photos that they utilized to examine the storm's activity. They discovered that the central storm is surrounded by an anticyclonic ring that rotates counterclockwise to the primary cyclone. The researchers contend that this ring might help to stabilize the system. The storms on Jupiter strikingly illustrate the powerful meteorology that can take place on other planets. The North Pole of Saturn, another gas giant planet, is covered by a massive hexagonal jet stream, which has even been reported to alter color. Strange but true, Jupiter and Venus's orbits influence Earth's climate, according to new research. Did you know that the weather patterns on Earth can be affected by planets' orbits that are hundreds of millions of miles away? As stated in a new study released on Monday, gravitational forces from Jupiter and Venus gradually alter Earth's temperature and life forms every 405,000 years. This pattern, which has existed for at least 215 million years, helps scientists more precisely date geological events like the dispersal of dinosaurs. According to the study lead author Dennis Kend, a paleomagnetism specialist at Columbia University's Lamont Doherty Earth Observatory and Rutgers University, scientists can now be able to link changes in the climate, environment, mammals, dinosaurs, and fossils in the world to this 405,000-year cycle in a precise way. According to scientists, the cycle has continued to exist for hundreds of millions of years, from the time before the emergence of dinosaurs. According to Kent, a researcher of the Earth's magnetic field, the climate cycles are intimately tied to how the Earth orbits around the Sun, and tiny differences in sunlight reaching Earth contribute to temperature and biological changes. Because of their size and proximity, Jupiter and Venus have such potent influences. Why Venus has such an influence on Earth? Venus is the planet closest to us, with a maximum distance of about 162 million miles, and has a mass comparable to Earth's. As for Jupiter, despite it being significantly farther away, it is the largest planet in the solar system. According to a study, seasonal variations on Earth intensify once every 405,000 years, due to gyrations in our orbit, brought on by the gravitational attraction of the two planets. Winters are chilly, and summers are hotter. Dry periods are drier, and wet times are wetter. More rain falls during the cycle's peak in the tropics, allowing lakes to swell. In contrast, Kent noted that at the other end of the cycle, tropical seasonal rains are fewer, and lakes have far less of a tendency to become as full. According to the findings, the most consistent astronomical pattern connected to the Earth's yearly rotation around the Sun is the 405,000-year cycle. And as the most recent high was roughly 200,000 years ago, we are currently in the middle of another cycle. The human influence. When compared to how humans are altering the planet, such as by burning fossil fuels, the impact of the planet on climate is negligible. The number of other factors that can have an impact on climate on timescales that are important to humans is extremely large, according to Kent. All the carbon dioxide we're pouring into the air right now is the obvious big enchilada, Kent said. That's having an effect we can measure right now. The planetary cycle is a little more subtle. Which planet has the worst climate? Venus is surrounded by a dense atmosphere made up of carbon dioxide and sulfuric acid clouds. These work as greenhouse-like units to trap heat and warm the globe. Venus's average temperature is a sweltering 847 degrees Fahrenheit, and that's way hotter than any life form on Earth can withstand. Which planet experiences the most severe weather? The size of Neptune is roughly 4 times that of Earth. In our solar system, Neptune experiences the most severe weather. It is the windiest planet, with storms seen spinning over its surface and freezing winds blowing almost 10 times faster than hurricanes on Earth. Are there any planets that affect Earth's tides? Some scientists have stated that contrary to what the most recent astrology charts claim, the planets in the solar system are too far away to have any impact on Earth. The combined gravitational forces of attraction of the Sun and the Moon control the majority of Earth's tides. However, because each planet has its unique gravitational pull, the other planets also have a negligible impact on the tides. Venus is the most powerful, since it is closest to Earth. But even at its peak, it has 10,000 times less of an impact than the Sun and Moon together. Venus is more powerful than even Jupiter, which is a huge planet, by less than a tenth. Therefore, the influence of the planets on Earth's tides is essentially non-existent. Effects of climate change. Although we frequently imagine that climate change brought on by human activity will occur in the future, it is actually a current process. Communities and ecosystems, both domestically and abroad, are currently being impacted. Between 1901 and 2020, the average global temperature increased by 1.98 degrees Fahrenheit. But climate change encompasses more than just a rise in temperature. Sea level rise, modifications to weather patterns like drought and flooding, and many other things are also included. The effects of a changing climate are being felt in areas that we depend on and value, such as water, energy, transportation, wildlife, agriculture, ecosystems, and human health. A difficult problem. The effects of climate change on several societal segments are interconnected. Food production and human health can be harmed by drought, while flooding has the potential to spread illness and harm infrastructure and ecosystems. Future scenarios that could occur due to climate change are not inescapable. We already know a lot of the issues and potential fixes, and continuing study keeps surfacing new ones. By limiting warming and hastening the transition to zero emissions, experts believe there is still time to prevent the worst possible outcomes. However, it will be necessary to invest in new technology, and technology to reduce our emissions of greenhouse gases, which will create jobs. Reducing emissions will also have a positive impact on human health, saving countless lives and billions of dollars in medical costs. Climatic change on our planet. Our globe is being affected by climate change from pole to pole. Here are some of the changes that the NOAA has observed in the data it collects on the world's climate. From 1901 to 2020, the world's temperatures increased by about 1.8 degrees Fahrenheit. Since 1993, sea levels have increased by 1.7 millimeters per year. The average thickness of 30 well-studied glaciers has decreased by more than 60 feet since 1980, indicating the glaciers are thinning. Since 1979, there has been a 40% decrease in the amount of sea ice that covers the Arctic at the end of the summer. Since 1958, there has been a 25% increase in atmospheric carbon dioxide levels, and there has been a 40% increase since the Industrial Revolution. When compared to long-term averages, snow is melting earlier. So guys, do you think it's possible that Jupiter's wild storms can have any significant effect on our climate here on Earth? Let us have your thoughts in the comments section, and we'll see you next time.